הדבר הבא שאני רוצה להגיד, אני רוצה להודות לשופטים שעשו עבודה מצוינת בבחינה של החברות. רוב השופטים של החלק הראשון נשארו לחלק השני. לצערי, דיקן הנדסה באוניברסיטת תל אביב, פרופסור יוני רוזנבקס, לא הצליח להגיע לכאן היום. אבל אתם, יש לכם את רשימת השופטים בדפים שלכם, בדפים ששלחנו ותלינו. הצטרפו אלינו שלושה שופטים חדשים לחלק השני. אחת מהן היא מיכל וקרת וולקין, שיושבת כאן לפנים. השופט שני שהצטרף זה אופיר, אופיר מה? אין לי פה את הרשימות, מקרן ברד. יובל, סליחה, יובל מקרן ברד. ושופטת שלישית היא מיטל סטבינסקי מחברת עורכי דין מאוד מאוד מעניינת בשם גרינברג טורי. אז אני מציעה שהשופטים ישבו כאן מקדימה, יהיה לכם נוח לשמוע את החברות ולשאול שאלות. אז אנחנו מתחילים בסולר פיינט, ואירן מיימון, בבקשה.
תודה רבה, שומעים? Earlier this year, Dr. צבי תבור has won the award for contribution to society. He won this award for his disruptive invention of coating for domestic solar water heaters. And since the 50s, we can all take showers in hot water. And also, Israel was the leading country in solar energy for several years to come. Hello, my name is Eran Maimon. I am the CTO of Solarpaint, and we will be disruptive. Now, we all know the amazing advancement in the solar arena in the past decade with gigawatts and gigawatts of installed capacity in utility-scale power plants and on rooftop installation as well. However, in recent years, the innovation in this field is quite stagnant, and the small improvements that are being made do not address several major issues that are a problem in the current technologies. What first is the huge spaces that are needed for these utility scale plants. The second is the high cost of the installation. And third, the inadequacy of a lot of space of surfaces to accommodate these bulky solar panels. But imagine, what if we could use any surface that is used for other purposes and transform it into a functional solar harvesting system? Simply and cheaply, just by painting it. This concept we call solar paint. You just paint it, connect it, and that's it. Imagine the impact. Imagine the potential for that. Rooftops, walls, roads, actually any surface that is just lying down in the sun and warms up. We are making this vision a reality. For this, we've gathered a very strong and interdisciplinary team with experts in solar energy, in business development, chemistry, nanotechnology. We've established a company and we got seed funding. Now we're working on R&D in the Technion in a laboratory there. And we're making there our low-cost solar paint prototype. This prototype is based on oxides, which are cheap and stable. You know, rust cannot rust. And actually, it should hold around 10 years. And with the current materials that we've chosen, we should expect efficiencies of around 8%. This is all possible through novel technologies that are now possible, that have been developed in the past decade in laboratories around the world, which enable very precise control of both geometry and morphology of the nanoparticles. And what's best about it is that it's made by wet chemistry techniques, which are highly compatible with current traditional paint manufacturing techniques. That can make our R&D cycles cheaper and also make the scale-up very easy. So how does it work? We take our proprietary electrode, selective electrode mesh, and apply it on our surface. This is where we take out the different charges. Over this net, we paint our oxide-based paint. And once it's cured, all you have to do is connect it to the peripherals, to the inverters, to the inverters and whatnot. Depends on-grid, off-grid, and voila. We've applied for patents for this technology, and we actually, for this application, for buildings, we get an ROI of around 3 years. But since you're going to paint your house anyway, and probably pay someone to do it, then the ROI drops down to 1.7 years. Our long-term goal is to go and apply our paint on roads. If you consider 80,000 square kilometers of roads, only of highways, only in the U.S. mainland, and you multiply that by a modest 5% efficiency paint, you get 8,000 terawatt hours per year, which is twice the amount of energy that produced today in the U.S. as a whole.
Three,
now that's
two,
an impact.
One.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Eran. Now the judging committee can use the next 5 minutes to ask questions. Well, I have a question. And the question is, we know blazing roads, blazing solar roads, something.
Solar freaking roadways?
Yeah, exactly. The Indiegogo, is it?
Yeah.
What is your positioning vis-a-vis other technologies trying to do something very similar?
Okay, so if you go to what's called solar paint, if you look at Google, almost all the companies that are pursuing this name are actually talking about solar ink. So their idea is to print on ITO or other transparent glass and make very cheap solar panels. But our idea is to make the panel in the place that we need it. And it can take any form that we want. So we don't sell panels, cheap or not cheap. That would put us in direct competition with the Chinese, and we don't want that. We just apply our, we make the solar panel in place. Now, if you talk about the solar freaking roadways, I hope they can solve all our regulatory issues, because I think they still have a chance on putting some commercials in Las Vegas parking lots and things like that. But if they can make it cheap enough, that's great. I don't believe they can. But I hope. Yeah. So we are now that's our roadmap. And as you can see, in 2016, we're about to launch a commercial pilot. Right now we're working on our prototype. Should be ready in less than a year now. And then we continue on a commercial product, then partnership. So we still have several years on the, down the road. Yeah, so the first 10 pages of Google are actually solar ink. That's what I referred before in the last question. There's almost no one that claims that there are two companies that claim that in the future they are planning to do it as solar paint. They usually state that because it sounds cool that you spray your house. But then when you go into the technology, they're actually doing panels or printing on panels. The second one, what was the second question? Oh, the cost. So, yeah, the cost of a system that we've calculated for 1,000 square meter is $72,600. This is an estimate with a lot of paint, which is not very, which was an expensive paint. You can see the addition of the pretreated net is actually is not very high, and most of the cost is fixed. It's due to the connections to the inverters and all the rest of it. The price can per kilowatt, you have to divide 72,600 by 1,000 by 0.5. Okay, this is something that we have very good ideas of how to do it, but they are general ideas. They are written in the patent, but we try not to think about them too much because it's a waste of time right now. We do have some very nice ideas of how to approach it. Yeah, so the paint is based on oxides, which should be very stable. They are very stable, they don't degrade. But if you look at paints that are made by oxides, they last around 10 years. After that, it's not that the paint itself is degrading, but it peels off. Or it gets foiled or dampened or things like that. So it depends on the additive that you add to the paint, except for the active materials.
Eran, we have to move on. Thank you so much.
Thank you.